a great situation for us because rap music was becoming increasingly profitable market for our companies, and as employees we'd be able to buy personal stocks in these prisons. Immediate silence came over the room. You could have heard a pin drop. I remember looking around to make sure that I wasn't dreaming and saw half the people with dropped jaws. My daze was interrupted when someone shouted, "Is this an effing joke?" At this point, things became chaotic. Two of the men who were part of the unfamiliar group grabbed the man who shouted and attempted to remove him from the house. A few of us, myself included, tried to intervene. One of them pulled a gun and we all backed off. They separated us from the crowd and all four of us were escorted outside. My industry colleague, who had opened the meeting earlier, hurried out to meet us and reminded us that we had signed an agreement and would suffer the consequences about speaking publicly with those, or even with those who attended the meeting. I asked him why I was involved with something so corrupt, and he said it was bigger than the music business, and nothing we'd want to challenge without risking consequences. We all protested as he walked back into the house. I remember word for word the last thing he said, "It's out of my hands now. Remember, you signed the agreement." He then closed the door behind him. The men rushed us to our cars and actually watched until we drove off. A million things were going through my mind as I drove away, and I eventually decided to pull over and park on the side of the street in order to collect my thoughts. I replayed everything in my mind repeatedly, and it seemed very surreal to me. I was angry at myself for not having taken a more active role in questioning what had been presented to us. I'd like to believe the shock of it all is what suspended my better nature. After what seemed like an eternity, I was able to calm myself enough to make it home. I didn't talk to call anyone that night. The next day, back at the office, I was visibly out of it, but blamed it on being under the weather. No one else in my department had been invited to the meeting. I felt a sense of guilt for not being able to share what I had witnessed. I thought about contacting the three others who were kicked out of the house, but I didn't remember their names and thought tracking them down would probably bring unwanted attention. I considered speaking out publicly at the risk of losing my job, but I realized I'd probably be jeopardizing more than my job, and I wasn't willing to risk anything happening to my family. I thought about those men with the guns and wondered, who were they? I had been told this was bigger than the music business, and all I could do was let my magic run free. There were no answers, no one I could talk to. I tried to do a little bit of research on private prisons, but didn't uncover anything about the music business's involvement. However, the information I did find confirmed how dangerous this prison business really is. Days turned into weeks, weeks turned into months. Eventually, it was as if the meeting had never taken place. It all seemed surreal. I became more reclusive and stopped going to any industry events unless professionally obligated to. On two occasions, I found myself attending the same function as my former colleague. Both times, our eyes met, but nothing more was exchanged. A great situation for us because rap music was...